Hello and welcome to Let's Read the Books of Enderal. Today I'll be reading The Path, Tome 10, The Order, which I bought right here in the Ark Library in the Noble's Quarter. Tome 10, The Order. Verse 75. The country's capital was steadily growing. The vassals furnished their homes and began to raise families. Even Selna became aware of a child in her womb, the fruit of her love with her late spouse Keteran. Humbly she kneeled in the Sun Temple in front of the great statue of Malphus and prayed to him. "Which path shall my offspring tread, Malphus? You spoke to us and led us to this land, but how shall our descendants, who are born here, find their path?" Verse 76. Then Malphus spoke to Selna, "Hear my words and proclaim them to all vassals. Each of your children shall receive their path consecration at the age of 8. Those who devote their life to becoming a priest of mine shall conduct the ceremony, and through them I shall speak and assign to each child their path. He will be told if he is going to be a sublime, an erudite, or a manufacturer, and he will receive a task which he shall fulfill path-abidingly, for he will not want to become a pathless one, who treads banished from the divine order and godly protection." Verse 78. "But your son, who you still carry within you, Selna, will receive his path from me right now. He shall become the first Grand Master of the Holy Order, who will fill this temple with life from now on. And you, Selna, will instruct him in this task from the day of his birth as his mother and servant, the first Truchessa of the Order." Verse 78. Humbly, Selna heard the voice of the Lightborn, and she declared his words on the great forecourt of the temple, after representatives of all the vassals' families had gathered there. Verse 79. And she declared even more of Malphus's will. "The temple shall host those who wield a sword in the name of Malphus to guard the path-abiding ones in Enderal, as well as those who record and proclaim his teachings against their foes." Verse 80. "There shall be a sanctum in the Sun Temple to pray to Malphus and to indulge in his wisdom. There shall be a chronicum to lay down all the teachings and events of the coming ages in order to educate and illuminate the temple. There shall be a curarium to provide healing to the ill and wounded of the Holy Order. There shall be an emporium to provide the Grand Master and his loyalists a refuge in their mutual pursuit of guiding the Order in serving Malphus's will." Verse 81. "Not only were children born, but the vassals dead were also mourned. When the first of the elderly had died, Selna, the Truchessa, brought him to a sanctum and laid him on a bier in front of the Lightborn statue." Verse 82. "And yet again Malphus spoke to Selna, 'Do not bring your dead here. If they were path-abiding, carry them to a place which had been important to them in life, and burn their body in the fading light of a setting sun. If they have unfailingly followed their destined path, I will accept them in the eternal paths above the firmament before dawn's first light. They will dwell in a place where no mortal will ever enter, and fortune, peace, and unity reign.'" Verse 83. "Those who have not followed their path loyally, I shall send back to begin a new life, with new tasks and trials, until they tread their path faithfully to the end. Then they, too, will be allowed to ascend to the eternal paths." Thank you for listening to Let's Read the Books of Enderal, The Path, Tome 10, The Order. Thank you.